please make an inspection of your wardrobe for your casual wear?
Not especially. Not especially because I don't know that much about clothes. It doesn't make a difference, really.
However, you have become a little bit more conservative.
Well, yeah. You get a little older, you know. That's like the sideburns. They were okay for a while, but they're outgrowing.
Don't you mess them?
The sideburns?
Yeah.
Not especially, no. The army took care of those. If I answer that, I lose a lot of friends.
How about the rumor about Nancy Sharp?
Is Nita around you anywhere? No, I don't know. It was just one of those deals, you know. I just dated her for a few times. It's kind of funny. You go out with a girl and a couple times, and it's a big romance, you know. Right. They had me married a couple times. I was down on Wilshire Boulevard one night, and some people. I was in the lobby of a theater. Some people said, "I thought you were in Mexico City on your honeymoon." And I come to find out that it was in a Mexican paper that I was eloped and was coming there to get married. And they had a hotel suite reserved and all that stuff. And I even know the girl I was supposed to be married to. Things like that happen.
Yeah, most show people have superstitions.
Well, I'm pretty superstitious. About certain. You talking about black cats, things like that?
Anyone in particular.
No, just little things like breaking mirrors, things like that. Photographers. Who said that? That's your line.
Elvis, do you still consider Anita Wood just a friend?
Well, yeah. I mean, I see her quite a bit, but there's nothing. There's nothing really, really serious. I see a lot of people quite a bit. These photographers are taking pictures of each other now.
Elvis, do you do much thinking ahead?
Quite a bit, yes.
Just enough thing to take the course. What do you see your place in the European world 10 years
from now? Well, I'll tell you, Mr. Johnson, I wouldn't say, because the entertainment world is so unpredictable and people change and times change. It would be hard to say, really. I wouldn't try to answer that, because the only thing I can say is that I'm trying to make it acting, you know. I mean, it takes a long time, and a lot of work, a lot of experience. But I'm trying to make it that way, and if I can get established that way, I'm okay.
Take your money, get away from it all.
The government won't let me take my money, get away from it all.
Elvis?
No, I enjoy it. Anytime I want to be alone, I can be, you know.
Well, I know,
but it's
pretty tempting people trying to get at.
But these are the type of things that you take advantage of while they last. You know, you take advantage of it because you may not have it later, and you'll miss it, you know. You'll miss the people, you'll miss all the razzle-dazzle and so forth. Well, I have a pretty good time. And so forth.
Always feel like home when you get back to Memphis.
Yes, sir, I do.
Good.
Sure does. That's one reason that I'll keep a home here, because I like California. I like to work there. But when the picture's over, I look forward to getting out of there and coming back home. And also, I'm right near Tupelo, and I know a lot of people down there. Same old crowd that I was raised up with still live there in the same houses. I was down there about 3 weeks ago. And the wind had blown the sign down. I got, well, that youth center being built, they got a big sign up. The wind had blown it down. We tried to put it back up, and it fell on us. There was three of us trying to lift it back up. The sign fell on us.
Did you anticipate the youth center being damaged?
I couldn't tell you. It's going to take a lot of money. But it will be eventually. I couldn't say when. But I'm trying to make it that way, and if I can get established that way, I'm okay. But now, I don't know how long the music end of it will last. I don't know how long I'll last. I got no idea, really.
Now, you only have two persons down at the plant.
Right.
You plan to go barnstorming again?
Well, the colonel could probably answer that better than I. There's nothing planned right now. I know that eventually we've got to do a European tour to all these countries like that presented these awards and things, you know. But I don't know exactly. Are we going to be doing any?
We're waiting for
the bus. He said that. I didn't say
that.
What's your weight now, Alice?
180.
What were you when you came out about a year ago?
175 when I came out. I gained about 5 pounds.
Love me tender, love me sweet, never let me go. You have made my life complete, and I love you so. Love me tender. Love me tender.
rock and roll is what they call him. With music in his soul, there stood a man. There had never been a king before him, and surely there won't be a king again. His memory lives on and lasts forever. His memory lives on and lasts forever. But never again will he sing his sweet songs for men. For God has taken him. They call secluded, but never did he take her own again. Loved by the millions of fans who knew him, and now mourned by the billions at his grave. And his memory lives on in our lives.
But no matter how silly, my pictures always made money. Paramount used it to make back for Peter O'Toole, Richard Burton. Why couldn't they spend it on making rich with me? And the Colonel turned down dramatic roles because there was no music. You see, all the movie songs went through the Colonel, and they sucked like donkeys. The son of a bitch took 50% of everything from me. Then he shaked down the writers for 50% of their cut. The result was the best songwriter stayed away. And I got old-fashioned songs that didn't maintain my singing career. I couldn't burn manure in music, man. I tried to fight the Colonel, but I realized I'd have to finish up my movie contract to win back my audience.
Well, why did you stay with the Colonel?
I was a very loyal person. I was taught to obey his elders, no matter what. And when I went to Germany, the Colonel worked hard to keep me as a star. Anyway, I wasn't concerned with the business of my career. You know, I was concerned with my fans. And being the best I could be for them. A lot of entertainers can tempt their audience, but not me.
Did you like doing the fight scenes?
Oh yeah, and there was fights in every picture. And I had learned karate in the army, and it was new Hollywood at the time. Once I even punched my horse. He wouldn't listen to me, wouldn't stop. So I punched him, and after that we were friends. I liked the cowboy moves. I embossed some horses and rode up Graceland.